Hello guys, welcome to Fabulistic Fashion Brand, where we learn how to sew different styles and designs, how to make Ankara bag, Ankara shoes and so on. So if you are here in this channel, you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, just click on the red button below to subscribe and God bless you as you do so. So today I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make a kimono jacket. Let's go to the cutting table.
Now knowing the amount of fabric to use, you are going to take the biggest part of your measurement, which is the hips measurement.
The benefit we get from now, that means.
So now you are going to divide your hips measurement. Your hips is your biggest measurement of your body. These are the measurements we are using for this tutorial today. The shoulder measurement is 14. The under bust length. The under bust length is 10. Our hips length is 23. Full length 27. Bust round 28. Under bust round 26. And hips round 32. So these are the measurements of the person. So now the biggest measurement we are going to be using is the hips measurement. So now we are going to divide our hips measurement by 4. Let's do that now. So a hips round is 32. This is 32. So now we are going to divide 32 by 4. This is 32 by 4, and this is what we have. We have 7.5 and 3/4. 7.5 and 3/4. So from here, you place your tape like so. You take your 7.5 and 3/4, you mark it. Then you add your 2-inch sewing allowance. This 2-inch will be used for your sewing allowance. Be looking at me. So after that, you shift your material back to your 2-inch allowance. You shift it back to that 2-inch allowance. You can see it. So the full length of this kimono is 27 inches. So now we are going to place our tape like so and mark our 27 here. These are 27 inches. You mark it.
Some people can do when they are still young.
You mark your 27 inches. Then we are adding 2-inch sewing allowance. The 2-inch will be used for as a bending allowance. We use it for our folding. So you add your 2 inches here. So after that, we are going to take our shoulder measurement. You divide your shoulder by 2. When taking the shoulder measurement, you divide your shoulder by 2. So the shoulder we are using for this tutorial is 14 inches. Now 14 divided by 2 is 7 inches. 14 divided by 2 is 7. We mark our 7 here. So now we'll come down here by 1 inches for our shoulder slope. We'll mark 1 inches for our shoulder slope. Then we connect it down to this point. You can see how we connect it. So for the neck, we'll be using 3 inches, 3 by 2.5, because we are making this dress for a little girl. So we'll be using 3 by 2.5, 3 by 2.5. So now you take it down, you connect. This is your shoulder slope. Now from here, you place your tape. You take your under bust length. Her under bust length is 10 inches because it's for a little girl. Then the hips length is 23 inches. Her hips length is 23 inches. Then this is the full length of the gown, which is 37 inches. So from here, you place your armhole round. A armhole round is 16, and 16 divided by 2 is 8. So you mark your 8 here.
So now we're going to be placing our round measurements. We're going to be placing our round measurements. Where her bust armhole length is where her bust round will be, and where her under bust length is where her under bust round will be, and where her hips length is. Where our hips length is where we're gonna be placing our hips round. So let's get there. Now the bust round is 28 inches. We are going to divide 28 inches by 4. Now 28 divided by 4, what we have is 6 1/2 3/4. So now we'll mark our 6 1/2 3/4. We'll mark it here. Then we add our 2 inch allowance. This 2 inch will be served as our sewing allowance. So now we'll be placing our underbust round. This is our underbust line. Remember. So now where our underbust line is where we're gonna be placing our underbust round. So you divide your underbust round by 4. The underbust round is 26 inches. So now we'll divide 26 by 4. Now 26 divided by 4, what we have is 6 3/4. Now you place your 6 3/4 here. You chalk it. And you add your 2 inch allowance. So now the next measurement we're gonna be placing is our hips round. Our hips round. So now we'll take our hips round. A hips round is 32 inches. Now we'll divide our 32 inches by 4. So 32 divided by 4, we have 7 1/2 3/4. We have 7 1/2 3/4. So now you place it here. This is the 7 1/2 3/4. You chalk. So after marking your hips by 4, you add your 2 inch allowance. The 2 inches will be served as your sewing allowance. So from there, so after which you connect from here. Down to your hips. So from here you connect it straight to your full length and your 2 inches allowance. So after that you cut it out. So after cutting it out, for the back neckline, we'll be using 3 by 1.5, or we can make use of 1. Let's make use of 1 for this tutorial because it's a kimono for a little child. So from there we'll connect it down and make use of our scissors to cut it out. So here is the front and this is the back. So that is all for this tutorial today. Thanks for watching my video. God bless you. And if you haven't subscribed, just click on the red button to subscribe, like and share my video. God bless you. Thank you for watching this tutorial.